Hi, this is continuation of my email regarding the CKYC upload. Let me discuss about what you have to do once you download the Excel utility. Like this is the downloaded folder. You can see one help file and the CKYC file, Excel utility. So I'm just copying and put it in another folder. Like in my D colon, I have created a test and created a folder. Wherever you want, you just create a folder and just paste it. And let me open the help file. In this window, I already told you, because Microsoft, any of Microsoft version plus Microsoft Excel is required to run this program. Also, you have to change the regional setting in your computer. It is like you just start search control panel. Here you can see region, change time, date and everything. And please ensure this is, once you selected India here or UK English, automatically the short date will, this date format will appear as DDMY. You just apply, because I have already selected previously, that's why I could not able to do apply here. Apply, you should click apply and OK. And another thing is folder options. Folder options means while we are uploading the data, in most cases we can see some .db file generating when you are putting a picture or something in a folder. So if you upload this .db file also with the CKYC, in the CKYC portal, it will shows that your files containing error or something. So for that, you have to click on the control panel and view folder options. I'm just selecting the folder options. Click on the view tab and you can see, you should tick this one. Always show icons, never thumbnails. And you just click apply and OK. So once you have done this, this thumb files will not generated in your folder. You just check it in case there is a thumb file in your folder. There is no other option. You just create another folder after configuring this folder options and just copy paste whatever your required files into that, like photo, ID proof, address proof, whatever. Okay, this is over, and this is the WinZip version. Any version will do, WinZip. Okay, so this part is over. So I'm just going here. As I told you, create a folder in any drive. I just created a folder as CKYC. You can, it's your choice, whatever folder name you can provide. Paste the Excel file into that folder. Yeah. So I have done that and just open this Excel file. This is Excel 2019 version. So here you can see enable. Also, you can see macro have been disabled because there is some coding in this software. So because of the security purpose, Windows will disable that function automatically. So you just enable the macros. It is depends on different versions where this macro shows. In 2010, it shows under the window menu. So you, if you Google it, you can find it out. Or if you have any confusion, let me know which Excel version you are using, then I will help you on that. In 2009, it is like that. Okay. So you just save it to keep that macro enabled. Once you have done, it's over. And Here you can see this is the input sheet, and you can see some fields over here. Basically under CKYC there are 122 fields they are providing. Like, you can provide whatever information you can give, but the thing is that if I provide all the columns here, then it will be like it's a wide spreadsheet you have to update. So I have reduced as much as I can, and let us discuss on that. This is the first column. Each and every column I have shown the length of that field also. So let us start with the first one. What is custID? CustID, in the sense of customer ID, whenever a customer comes to your organization, you have to register that customer, right? So that custID is this. So for time purpose, I have given as 101 here. And I will show you what you have to do with this custID. In the same folder, right now you can see only this Excel and the help utility. The same folder, you have to create one folder. 101 with the same name, whatever you are providing here as custID, same name, you have to create a folder in this wherever you have put this as utility. And under that, a photo is compulsory for that customer, right? So I'm just kept some files here, so let me copy that. I'm just putting in that folder. So the very first one, whenever a customer comes, a photo is required, right? So I just putting a photo here, and the photo name should start from the custID 101. So I just click F2, 101, and you should provide an underscore, and the name should be PHOTO. If you provide this photo with suppose there is a instead of underscore you have provided a hyphen or whatever, it won't or if you don't provide the underscore, it won't accept the data. You will get the message from CKYC like your format is wrong or picture not found, something like that. This is the format, we can't do anything on that. This is the only format CKYC accept, photo. Okay, so like that, if photo I already discussed, and another thing is that a proof of address is compulsory for each and every person. Proof of address in the sense Aadhaar card, we can provide it as proof of address and proof of ID also. In case suppose you are providing a PAN card of that party, then it should be 101 underscore POI, proof of address. You can't put anything behind before, nothing. You should provide the name like this only, 101 underscore POI. It's a PAN card. And another thing is that proof of address, this is also compulsory. So you can provide Aadhaar card, voter ID, whatever, Aadhaar card, voter ID, or what we say, driving license, everything you can provide it. You can provide, it should be 101 underscore proof of address. The short is POA. So this is the files names you should provide in that folder. So I told you, I'm repeating once again. You are putting a customer registration number here, and with the same name you have to create a folder, and you have to put a photo of that customer and a proof of address and POI, proof of identity. This proof of identity is not compulsory in case of like you are providing Aadhaar, proof of ID is not compulsory. But there is another criteria, we will discuss about it In case you don't have the PAN card of that customer, so you have to provide the father name of that customer. That is also will do. We will discuss about it. So, as I told you, photo, there is some configuration behind it. I will show you. What I can see. Photo resolution. Yeah. These are the criteria they are providing about the resolution of a photo. Like, document should be scanned in grayscale with a scanning resolution of 150-200 dpi. Photo must be recent size, recent passport style picture, preferably in color, dimension 20-30 pixel. Size of photograph should be less than 50 as acceptable format, so and so. File size maximum should be 350 for an individual record. So as per our discussion, I'm just opening this folder. If you just keep this your mouse on this folder, you can see what is the size of this folder. Can you see? This is 180 KB altogether, so it will work. So these are the 2-3 conditions. I'm just removing these things because in my program I have accept only JPEG files. I will show you how to do that. If you have a PDF file, how to do that. First discuss about the photograph. Okay, this you just leave it, whatever the depth of this resolution, because if you scan the photo with a high resolution, that size will be high, simply as that. So in this case, you should ensure that the pixel dimension for this photo. So I will show you, like this folder, this photo, I'm just opening that. So I just downloaded, this is not as per their criteria. So what you have to do is that you just open MS Paint, Microsoft Paint. And sometimes you can see the background should be like this. So you just reduce this background first and just open this picture. So it will show like this, and just click on the print screen button. You can see in the right hand side, and or in laptop you should type function print screen. Okay, and just paste it in this file. One second, it's on the screen. Control V. You just put Control V. Can you see this? Yeah, after that, there is a provision here to select the area. So you just click here and select that portion here, because this much dark side I don't require. So I just selected this area. I just copy it. You just do copy, like, and open another file, new, don't save, and just put it as Control V. So this area is selected for this photo, and don't click anywhere. After that, what you have shown in the notepad is dimension should be 200 into 230 pixel. Okay, so you just click on the resize. Can you see resize? In the resize, you just click pixel here, and what's the provision they have provided? 200 and 230. You just type, first you untick this maintain aspect ratio, and you just type 200 230, and just click OK. Can you see they have already configured the photo up to 200 230. So I just copy that. I did not click anywhere. You just remember that. I just copy. Do the same process again. File, new. Don't save. Control V. No, one second. You should reduce this background little bit less and Control V. See, the photo has been saved, and you should save it as the same file name. This 101. First, you close this photo and open Microsoft Paint and file save as. Click on the save as button, and here is an option type JPEG picture. Click on the JPEG picture or where you want to save, give that path and select that photo again. Yes, overwrite it. That's all. You just close this Paint. So this photo is configured as per the CKYC requirement. Can you see the file size is only 18.8 KB? Okay, the same way we can do the other files also, like POI, proof of address. Suppose this is a this proof of address is in the this form, like what we called in the PDF form. So you just open that and paste it in the same procedure. Paste it in the Paint and configure that. And this photo resolution is required only for the photo. Rest of the things, you should ensure that the total file size should be less than 350. Like, can you see what is the file size now? It is 175 KB only. Okay, so we have configured the photo ID proof and address proof. If there is no ID proof, this ID proof is not compulsory. You just put photo and proof of address. Like, PAN card is not provided by the customer, so there should be two files. One is photo and another is proof of address. Proof of address is compulsory. In case they have provided the PAN card also, so there should be three files in this folder. One is photo, one is proof of address, because in that PAN card you can't see any address. So this is the proof of address and this is the proof of identity. Okay, so the photo configuration is over. We are coming to the Excel file again. So this is the customer ID. We have created a folder in that name and put these three files, three or two, whatever you have. And next is applicant prefix. Mr. If it's a male, you can put Mr., Mrs., whatever. This is the applicant name. You can provide the applicant name, middle name. Also, you remember that in between any like dot, bracket, nothing will be accepted here. It should be without any characters like comma. Like this forward slash, nothing will be accepted, or hyphen, nothing will accept here. Okay, you just put the name without any this characters. And another is middle name. This is not the compulsory fields. If you have, you can put it as put it the data here. Like I can change it to like alter. Again, put a name here, his surname and last name, Pasuan. Not compulsory fields, whatever you can use. Another is father name. Father name, spouse name. Yeah, father name. In case you are not providing the PAN card of that customer, the father name is compulsory. So otherwise you put the spouse name in case you are providing the PAN card, or you just put the father name. So if this is not here, here it should be 01. The father name is compulsory. prefix of father name, his father name, and the mother name. This is for gender. This is also compulsory, mother name, father name, and these fields. This is the another field, male F, female, male M, female, it is F, like that. Another is marital status, whether it's married or unmarried, 03 others. So here the code is 01. You can put it as 1. If you put 1, CKYC will reject data. It should be 01 only. So the length should be 2. Can you see here? Length should be 2. Another is occupation. I have provided so many occupations here. What are the regular things? Like S02 is the service, private sector. If you doesn't know the exact job, like in case working in the private sector, you can put S02. So remember, you can put it as S02. So system will system will generate error. It should be S02, this 02 only. Okay. Another is date of birth. Date of birth should be in the DDMM YY format with a hyphen. You can put it as 20061962, like that. You can provide it. System will generate an error. It should be DD hyphen MM hyphen YY YY. This is the PAN number. In case PAN number is not here, not an issue, but then this file should be deleted, because there should be two files you are providing, proof of address and photo. So here I put PAN card, so I have to provide 3 IDs, proof of ID, a photo, proof of address. Okay. Another is the address. So you can see maximum character should be 55 without any dot or any something. PAN card, address 1, address 2, address 3, city, district, or the state code. The state code is compulsory. You should provide only 2 digits over here. Can you see? I have put almost all the states' codes, like Goa for it is GA, like Delhi it is a DL, Maharashtra it is MH, like that. So you can put it as Kerala. Maharashtra, like that. You should provide the capital letter S with the 2 digits. Okay. Pin code. Pin code is also compulsory. Without pin code, they won't accept the data. Another is proof of address. Proof of address is compulsory, as I discussed earlier. This file is not compulsory, but photo and proof of address is compulsory. So they are asking which type of address, proof of address you are providing. If it's other, you should provide 01. If it's passport, it should be 02. If it's a driving license, it is 03. Election ID, it is 04. You can't put it as 4 here, because they will accept only 2 digits for this field. So here, if you put 9 or 4, it should be provided as 04. In case you are getting, if you put 04 and the data is converting automatically to 4, so you just click Control Tab, or just right click and format cells, and you should select text here. In case you are normally all the fields should be in the general time. Like suppose I am dragging here and putting 5 4, so see it will left right hand to this cell, because it is a number, but this is the text field. So in this case, if you put 04, what will happen? That 0 automatically gone from there. So it should be, click on the Control 1 button or right click properties, click on the text, okay, and again you just put F2, put a 0 and enter. So it will be generated into text. Once you generate that, you can copy paste wherever you want. So automatically that fields will be converted into text field. If I put 4 here, it will go this like. But once you generated, once you formatted, if I put 4, it is a text field. Text field show in the left indent. No, number field shows in the right indent anyway. And next column is STD code, maximum length 04. These are not the compulsory fields. If you have, you can provide it. Contact number, like it's actually landline. STD code and landline number. It's a mobile number. This is date of declaration. This you should remember. It should be in the DDMA YY format, and it should be today's date. Like today is 23rd, so I am just putting 23rd 05 2019, otherwise it will reject the data. And as per this is the KYC verification date. As per the KYC now norms, we should submit the proof of our customer within 2 days or within 3 days, I think. So that's why I put a formula like this -2. So this means we got the data on 21st and uploaded it. And RBI also knows, because we will submit it little bit delay. So this is not a critical field, but we don't give an opportunity to RBI, like every day, every time you are submitting the CKYC very lately. So I just put a formula here, or you can directly type 21 05 2019, okay, like that. Another field is this. I have to explain it because there's a little bit confusion on this field. Number of records 30. If PAN number is not providing, it should be 02. So before going to this, I will tell you what is 30 and 70. This is the this is the format of the data CKYC assets. So like each and every record, we should provide like the row starts from 10. That means the heading. That means which is the institution and on which date you are submitting the data and how many records are there. These are the things we will provide in the header 10. And what is 20 record? 20 means it's a heading is 20, and this record means what are the information you are providing here in this row. Everything will come to this record 20. This should be around 5 to 6 fields, and this is, as I told, it is 121 fields. Another is 30. 30 means what are the ID numbers you are providing. That is the thing I have shown here, where it is this. Okay, so as I told, this case, in case I am providing proof of address and proof of identity, like simply telling this proof of address with the PAN card, you just think like that, photo, proof of address with the PAN card. So there should be two numbers, right? Proof of ID, like suppose Aadhaar, there should be an Aadhaar number, and PAN card is providing, there should be PAN card number. So you should provide two numbers here. One is PAN, one is address proof. Okay. And 70 means the 70 represents the files we are uploading, physical form. 70 first file should be photo. As I can see, as you can see, this is the photo. One, proof of address, proof of identity, that means PAN card. So three files I am providing. So I have to give that file name here. What is the file name here? 101_photo. So internally program, in the program I write 70 101 photo. Next is 70 101 PAN card, like proof of identity. 70 101_POA, proof of address. Giving you another example, like this PAN card is not here. I'm just suppose I'm deleting it. See, in this folder only two files are there, like this customer did not provide the PAN card to you. So photo and address, both things we have. So in this case, what this is for heading, this is for the record, this information, and ID I can see, you can see only one. This is the address proof. Address proof I am providing under 30, and files under 70 what? One is the photo and another is the address. Actually, you don't need to worry about these things, but I just, for information, I just discuss with you what are these 30 and 70. Maybe you will confuse whenever you are getting an error from the CKYC portal. Under 30, this is wrong, 70, this is wrong. So 70 means that there is some problem in the files you have provided, like name is wrong, like here POA is small letter, photo is small letter, like that. So they will provide error like 70, there is an error. In case that ID is not properly identified, provided, like you have provided passport, so passport expiry date is compulsory. In case you did not provide passport expiry date, so they will show you like in 30, this is the error, date is not given. So you can directly locate it. For that, I have just discussed with you. Nothing worry about it. So coming to this point, number of records 30, if PAN number is not providing, it should be 2. Like it should be not 1 or 2, it should be 2. 2. Like as discussed, there is no PAN card. So one photo, one proof of address. So the file should be 2. So number of records. It should be number of records in 30. If PAN not providing, it should be 1. Like this is about the 30. In 30, how much records you are providing? You are providing only the proof of address. So it should be 1 only here. In case you are providing proof of like PAN card also, so what are the additional fields you are providing? 2. So you should type here 2. You can't put 3 here, then it will give you additional error, whatever, blah 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 blah. Okay, and the next field is number of records in 70. So what I have mentioned, in if PAN is not providing, it should be 2. Like suppose this file is not here, then it should be 2. These two files you are providing. Otherwise, if you additional PAN is providing, it should be 3 records you are uploading. That's all. In case you have any confusion about these things, you can write mail. I will specifically brief that with another video. Otherwise, it should be very lengthy. Okay. Another one is voter ID. That means what are the IDs you are providing. This is the columns for ID. As I told, I am coming to this portion. What are the IDs you are providing? In case PAN number is providing, you should type here C. In this case, we are providing PAN number. So you should type here C. I have mentioned what is the codes for that. if you put F here or you put nothing, then they won't accept the data. So you put, if you provide PAN card, you put C. That's all. Okay, so in this case, I am giving PAN card and Aadhaar. So what I have to type here, PAN card and voter ID. So I am putting one PAN card. So this is over, and another is voter ID. So I put B here, and I type the voter ID here. Like another example, suppose this PAN number you are not providing in this file. So You can see only two files in this folder. This PAN card is not providing. So it should be 1, it should be 2. And here what this thing, driving license I am providing here. Please remember, you don't cut anything from the first row. You should always copy the files in the first row, because there are some formulas in the backend. Here whatever you do, you can cut paste whatever. In the second row onwards, you can cut paste whatever you want to do, but in the first row, don't cut and paste anything. You can copy paste any data. Like from here, you can copy paste. Like this, but you can't cut and paste it here. You just remember that. Okay, so this is the ID I am providing. So I'm just deleting here. So only one ID I am providing, like here, right? The voter ID only I am providing. So in the first portion, first ID, I am putting the code as what, B4. Sorry, I have to put here. I have to put the B for voter ID and the voter number. In case I am providing passport, then it should be A, and this should be passport number, and there should be an expiry date for that. Like it should be a future date, remember. In case you are putting 18, it won't accept it because it's already expired. Expired ID is not acceptable. Okay. In case PAN passport is providing, your date is compulsory. In case passport is not providing, passport or driving license is not providing, this date is not mandatory. Okay. So in this case, we are providing only one ID. So here you should not do anything. It should be blank. In case PAN card is providing, please remember, you should provide PAN card in the first column itself. So I'm just deleting this. And here it should be C and the PAN card number. Like whatever PAN card number. So this date is not compulsory. So any confusion about these fields, please write to me. I will explain further. Okay. Another is records uploading in the 7D. Like these things, photo, PAN card, and the last column. What are the things you are providing in the as address proof? This is the ID proof we are providing. This is the address things. Sorry. So, as I told, what are the document you are providing as address proof, that you should provide it once again. So for that, as I told, I have given A. Suppose I am providing is A here, that A means passport. So I should put here 05 and the passport number and the expiry date also. You can copy paste it. Remember, don't cut paste. Suppose I am providing like what we called UID, voter ID, it should be 04 and the voter ID, whatever. So date is not mandatory. Here I am just Alt F2. This will confuse you. Okay, In case you are providing Aadhaar, it should be 04, and the 12 digit Aadhaar number. In case passport, it should be 05, and the passport number and the expiry date. If it's a driving license, it should be 06, driving license number and the expiry date. And if it's a zero voter ID, it should be 07 and the voter ID. So basically, whatever the details you are providing here should come here with the code change. Here, can you see, if for passport we are providing A in code here, but passport we are providing 05 here, like that is the difference. So you can copy that, paste it, and passport here the code is 05. Just to format it, click on text, okay, F2 05. If you put 5, it will reject it. Okay, so maybe the issue is only this part. Any confusion about this, let me know. I will make separate video. Any confusion about this also, let me know. I will make separate video. So basically, we have provided one record. Just saving it. Please ensure these details you have already configured, and you just click here view. Click on view. Here is a button called macro, view macro. Click on run. You should provide how many records you want to upload it. If you put 100, if you already filled 100 records here, you can put 100. If it's a 10, you can provide it as 10. For time being, I am putting 1. Just click OK. I am putting here it has 1 record. So automatically, one folder, one file, one zip file will be generated. Let us see what is inside that. Yeah, can you see one zip file? Once you extract it, WinZip, basically once you generated the zip file, login with the ID. That means there is an inputter and authorizer. There are two IDs for each and every CKYC login. So you just login with the inputter user ID, whatever the ID you have given me to upload the data. So you login with that DAC and click on the bulk upload option, and there's a drop down. Click on the new and upload this file. After that, the authorizer will login with his DAC, and he has to authorize under the bulk authorization upload. There is bulk authorization. There is a menu for that. You just click on that and select and upload. Once upload, after 5 minutes or 10 minutes, you can check the status under bulk upload response. So if it's successful, it will show you it is already successfully uploaded. If it's already uploaded by somebody, it will give you the information like with the CKYC number. Otherwise, they will provide you a reference number. So after 2 days, once you check with the reference number, CKYC, we can download it from the website. Right now, I did not incorporate that downloading option, bulk downloading option from the CKYC website. If you required, I can make it. It is not that much big thing. Okay, so that is the procedure. So let us discuss what is inside this file. So if in the most point, if you just keep the most point, you can see one zip file and a folder and a text file also. So let us extract it and see what is inside it. This is the file we have generated. This is the notepad. As I discussed, 10 is for the header, 20 is for the entire record. So Mr. Perumal, that is the file you can see here, this one. And where it is? Yeah, the 30 is the PAN number, and the address proof. This is the photo, this is the POI, and proof of address. Also, there is a folder inside that. So you just unzip that also. So you can see the files inside that. So this is the procedure to upload the data. So just delete it. So we just uploaded only one file. So let us upload one more file. Here you can cut paste and everything. On the first row only you can't cut paste. You can copy paste any data, but don't cut paste anything in the first row. Okay. So for that, this I'm providing 102. So the same time there should be a folder 102. Here I'm not putting PAN card. So here is also blank, right? So here it comes to rest I already discussed, so I'm not going into that. Here it should be how much is the files under record 30. Record 30 is only POA, proof of address. So it should be 1 here, and the total number of records, it should be number 2. That is why it is number 2 here. Remember, if you are uploading PAN card, here it should be 2 and here it is 3. If not uploading PAN card, it should be 1 and it should be 2. 2 means what? 1 address proof and 1 photo. Without that, you can't upload the data. Okay. Here is also I provide B, voter ID here. In the very first column, next column kept it as blank. And up to here. Yeah. And here I provide B, voter ID. So here is also 07 voter ID. So let us see what will happen once we run the macro. Again click on view macro, run, total number of records 2. The file is generated. This is the previous generated file. This is the new generated file. If you click on that, you can see 101 is one folder, 102 is another folder, and the notepad. Let us see what is in the notepad. See 101 and 102, and in the notepad you can see the second record. In 70, in the first record you can see 3 record, but in 70 you can see only 2 records, like that. Now let us do 10 record. I'm just deleting it, like F2 103 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110. Okay, I am uploading 10 records. 3, 4, 8, 9, 10. Here is also I am putting 10. Count is 10, so just click on macro, view macros, run. How many records you wish to upload? 10. Completed. In the folder, it's another folder is generated. Once you just keep drag on that, you can see 10. There are 11 files in this folder. That means 10 zip files plus one notepad. Extract. One ten zip files and one notepad. This is the program. Hope you understood. In case any issue regarding uploading this file, please let me know. Like, please put a mail to me. I will reply with a detailed reply. Maybe I think you have the confusion only about this part. So in case you need further clarification, of course I will provide you the details. Okay, thank you.